And Faircloth, nice to be here. Hello everyone.
Oh, is that me?
Hawaii?
Ads.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Now I want to go to Hawaii.
Alright.
Hey, clicked on the ambulance!
And...
Hey, everybody, how are you guys doing?
Man, what's causing that sound?
Yeah, feedback.
It's from us.
Oh, okay.
Are you sure?
It's like feedback.
We are, we're kind of working on our ATV setup a little bit. It's going to change up in the future. We know all these windows are kind of not a thing you like.
We're thinking of changing it up.
Yeah.
But we need to figure out how first.
Yeah, if you guys have suggestions,
So, how you doing, Ben?
Not too bad. How are you?
Great. I thought you had a bigger answer than that.
I got like 30 pages of stuff to write for a site tomorrow, but other than that.
How are those JavaPoint articles?
They are titles right now. I'm at the point, there's a point in the process where you start writing a JavaPoint article and you like write whatever the subject is. And it's Galactic Guy, better than First Battle Squadron. Then you just save it to the desktop, and then you stare at it for 48 hours. And then, like, at the last minute tomorrow at, like, 3 p.m., I'll write 1,000 words.
Trap Joe wants to know how he liked the Iron Brew. I can say it correctly this time.
I think I drank, like, 4 of them.
It was good.
It was good.
Oddly addicting. It was like cream soda meets orange-sicle.
Yeah, it's pretty. It's
like a creamsicle.
Yeah.
So this one thing, you decided.
It kind of tastes like bubble gum too.
It did taste like bubble gum.
Yeah.
It smelled like bubble gum at least.
Yeah.
Was it carbonated or uncarbonated?
It's carbonated.
Okay.
They're saying they're hard to hear, but I can move the mic as close to us as it possibly can be.
You know, I accidentally dropped the microphone on the floor right before we started.
Did you break the microphone?
I don't know. Just saying, it fell on the floor.
In 30 seconds, let us know if Allie broke the microphone, please.
So, Ben, how's the wreck controversy going?
It goes. it's one of those things, you know, we want feedback on it. None of it is final, especially the balancing stuff. I think we were all kind of let down by the reaction, you know. We're telling you exactly what we're thinking. We're not trying to screw you, and that seems to be the go-to. Let's get some good feedback.
Yeah, I think the follow up in today's ATV and the extended thing will.
All right, your mic seems to have died because of some reason. So swap with me.
Here.
I break microphones on purpose.
Why are you telling everyone to blame me?
There you go.
Yeah, it's been Yana's fault.
I didn't break the mic. I like how you say you knocked it over and they say it's my fault.
Well, I was trying to set this up because you were outside having a cigarette.
That's
James.
True.
Yeah.
It's not always.
Oh, no.
So it does all come back to Blaming James.
I don't need it there.
But do you want to repeat what you said, Ben?
What was I talking about? Wreck? Yeah, you know, we put this stuff out there because we want your feedback. There's no reason to fight about it, honestly.
Yeah.
As with anything in Star Citizen, we will adapt it to meet our vision if it doesn't work correctly.
I think people's just go-to is that whatever we say is like gospel, like this is our end plan, that we have ulterior motives for everything, but we really don't.
Well, yeah, it's so frustrating because, you know, we'll go out there and tell people, okay, this is how we want the game to work, and here's how we think it's going to work. And they'll focus on the second part, and they go, oh, it's never going to work, and you guys are... I get that it's not going to work. We've looked at the number. We think it should be done differently. That's totally great criticism. But just any like ongoing implication that it's like, oh, we're out to get them.
Yeah, that's the one I don't get. Like, I've said this before. Like, it behooves us not at all to pull one over on people.
If the rec system were like some terrible plan to screw you all out of money or, you know, ruin the game, make it freemium, all those things, we wouldn't tell you about it and ask you what we should change.
Yeah.
We would be a terrible business.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, you know, it's not everybody's fault. People have been abused by gaming companies for the last 5 years or so with this stuff. And
yeah, definitely.
And, you know, I was on Batgirl show yesterday, and I think we kind of came to the same conclusion that it's frustrating because the things that need to make a working economy in the Finnish Star Citizen are also the things that other people abuse to say why you have to pay EA extra money to build another building in SimCity.
Yeah.
So we are looking at that. We're looking at that end goal, I think, a lot more strongly than a lot of people realize.
Lord Percival, so to get MVP, we just need to spam invite people? No, that's exactly kind of what we were just talking about. Like, we tried to switch up MVP to be more, you know, to encompass more of the community, and because we weren't trying to pull one over on anybody again. Like, you know, we just thought it was an interesting way to do it, so if it doesn't work, we'll just change it. Like, you know, that's kind of what we're trying to say is, at no point do we think, oh, this will make people angry. We think, I wonder if people will like this, I guess is the mentality we always have.
I would say absolutely. And I mean, look at Arena Commander. You guys have watched it come together in exactly the same way we do everything at this company. It's a matter of starting with something and then perfecting it with your help, with the development team here.
If the orc thing, for example, the MVP, if the orc thing doesn't work and people don't like it, we won't do it.
Yeah, let us know. We'll adapt.
I mean, the whole show is evolving. We try new things, mm-hmm. and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Like, that's what we do. I mean, otherwise we grow stagnant and stale, and nobody wants to watch it. So,
like, you don't know how excited I was the news worked last week.
Yeah, we were very happy with that.
Yeah, that was not a for sure thing. That was something we wanted to do because we thought it would be a more interesting viewing experience. But we didn't know if it would work. Mm-hmm. Thankfully, it did, for the most part.
Yeah. I'd like to see us get images in there again. Yeah. Get there.
All right, what's that?
It's them. I don't know.
I don't know why it's doing that.
Well, Ben, what ship packs include with the four collector's box mentioned on ATV?
We're still working out the logistics for that, but I can guarantee you that if you are a consummate collector, we will have some option for you so you don't have to buy four games.
Although you should.
And we're going to put up the poll for that a little bit later today.
Will there be a way to permanently unlock larger ships like the Idris or Retaliator in our AC without needing to buy it in the PU?
Yes, down the road for sure.
When those ships are in AC.
Yeah, well, one thing you'll see is, you know, AC is the big focus. A lot of what we do with AC today is to drive people to test it in certain ways. You know, if you've seen, you know, we'll unlock a weapon in the PU, we'll unlock ships for redeploy for a weekend, we'll, you know, ask people to focus on some game mode or another. So it's very much the test bed right now. In the final Persistent Universe, when you happen to go to your SimPod and you want to play a game of Arena Commander, it's going to be a fairly different experience, and that there aren't the stakes involved for unlocking ships. So, you know, it will be much easier to simply say, okay, here's the Idris in AC, and nowhere else.
What's crumpling?
Ryan,
Legos.
You want to explain what all the crumbling is so we can get it out of the way? Let me get
my Legos.
Can you get all the plastic bags out?
Can we expect to see a pic of the Orion right now, Ben?
We can't expect to see a pic of the Orion right now, but you will see one tomorrow. One picture.
Say, Ben, do you think they'll have an in-depth piece about the Orion sometime next week on ATV?
We hope so. Is that a real question? Are you? we're actually going to shoot a little reenactment of an Orion design meeting right after this so you guys can see how this stuff comes together. So when you see the piece, and I'm wearing the same outfit talking about the Orion, movie magic.
It's feedback for whenever we stop talking, I think.
Keep talking. Why isn't Sandy's flight school being released as a separate video? It will.
It will be. Yeah, we wanted to have a couple in the can before we did them as a separate video. Otherwise, they just confuse the heck out of new users.
Yeah, my idea was once we finish all of them to, like, put them together in one long video.
I think once we get up to, like, four or five of them, we can have a separate video channel for them.
Okay. No. Okay. Well, we see AC 1.1 include the Gladius. Gladius.
Maybe.
Maybe.
I won't say no. But, you know, I want right now, looking like yes, but of course, you guys know how things go.
So yes-ish.
Yes-ish.
So they're asking if it's, we're going to snag George Hull for another ship, or if he's too busy with Jupiter Ascending too.
Actually, I saw he just finished, he did Chappie. He's going to be here for the Chappie premiere.
Dude, Chappie looks awesome.
I think Chappie looks awesome too. I have a friend on Twitter who's like just rails on it constantly for no reason.
Why?
It looks cool. Yeah, we would love to keep using him. He's fantastic. He has that, he has kind of a good, like, Navy warship look down, and he has, like, a good utilitarian style to his ships. So we like using him for our working ships.
Do we want to talk about Jupiter Ascending?
Well, yeah, we all saw Jupiter Ascending on, it looked beautiful, I will say that. I have no criticism of the effect.
It was pretty.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it made no sense. It was Alexis' favorite movie.
Mm-hmm.
What? Yeah, I think James actually liked it more.
I liked the space stuff, and then they started talking, and I was like, I'm out.
I facepalmed in the movie, literally my face.
It does.
And I shook my head.
I liked Channing Tatum's angel wings.
Yes.
And his guy makeup.
Yeah.
I looked back, and as he was sitting behind me, I looked back, and he was just sitting there, legs up on his phone. Like halfway through the movie, he had just given up. He's just like, F it.
That would be
any news on the reworked Avenger, Ben?
No, I think you'll see the cutlass first.
Okay. How is Chris doing today, Ben?
I haven't seen Chris today.
He's in a meeting, I saw.
But I actually am looking for him because I happen to have my Wing Commander helmet here. I've never asked Chris to sign anything before,
mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna worked up my nerve to do that.
When he talks about cybernetics, can we get cybernetics?
I don't know. I can answer that one.
Well, there's the thing where if you die or whatever, right?
Oh, the
death of a spaceman thing.
The spaceman stuff, yeah.
If you guys didn't, Travis and Darren gave an update that the work on the scout is started. So there's that update out of the way. Ben, what about the merchantman?
No updates on the merchantman. Sorry.
What about the Starfare?
I think we put out some of the new Starfare cockpit out the other day, maybe there's more to come.
Cool. Is it dangerous to talk to the chairman?
No. Here's the thing. Everyone is, like, intimidated and kind of terrified of Chris Roberts, except Travis Day. But...
That's true.
He's actually the nicest guy in the world. There's just this weird, like, shield you have to, like... work yourself up to.
Well, there's the whole boss thing. Like, he's the boss.
He's the boss.
And then there's like he's like a genius thing.
Yeah, he's. You always heard like Steve Jobs describe with that reality distortion field.
Yeah.
And you can kind of sense that with Roberts. Not that he's distorting reality, but there's something there.
There's magic.
Yeah, there's Chris Roberts' magic.
He's like the George Lucas of video games.
I think both of them would be offended by that.
Except he didn't come back 30 years later and ruin my childhood.
Well, give him time.
Lucas Academy Award nominated.
Hollywood's going off.
Did he win?
American Graffiti and Star Wars both. No, but he was nominated.
Exactly.
So, exactly. Sorry.
There it is, nailed it.
That George Lucas was Academy Award nominated filmmaker for his first two movies for both American Graffiti and Star Wars.
He just started speaking pretentious.
Undue amount of hate because of Jar Jar Binks. You know,
Jar Jar's
just because of Jar Jar Binks.
He's a Jar Jar.
Does it?
Binks was a pilot, sure.
And Ken likes Jar Jar Binks, don't you?
Yeah, Ken.
I was just making a point as to how much I love Star Wars. So, Jar Jar Binks might not be the coolest character, but, I mean, it's still Star Wars, it's pretty cool in my book. So,
loves Jar Jar Binks confirmed.
I will admit that I liked Jar Jar Binks.
What?
I'm going to receive hate mail.
It's annoying, but I
Jar Jar Binks head.
How old were we when that came out? I was 99, right? Or is that there's 99?
99, yeah.
So, we were 11?
I will say
I didn't like him.
I was in my 20s.
You guys are so young.
I will say that the thing that is much more problematic in terms of Jar Jar for me is the fact that George Lucas listened to the criticism and removed him from the other movies.
Yeah.
You watch the second and the third one, you're just kind of sad because clearly George Lucas has this like Santa Claus soul, and he's like, children will love my amazing character. He's so wacky. And then the internet happened to him. And he's like, okay, I'll just have Jedi's fighting and stuff.
I think the internet would have not been so kind to a lot of things.
I'll just have Jedi's fighting and stuff.
So I heard this argument that
I've seen Star Wars. I've seen all of them.
We're doing it again.
Whatever.
No, go ahead.
Oh, pobrecita.
Well, that's something to say.
I heard the argument that if the internet was around when the first Star Wars came out, that people may have had that same type of reaction to some characters from the original Star Wars. But because it wasn't, the next generation that got the 1 through 3 has this anger and resentment towards the first three.
I just think the internet would have treated films in general, all these films from the 80s that I like, you know, like The Last Starfighter or stuff like that. I mean, the internet would, you know, blast.
Yeah, it's like, oh,
yeah.
Rockhead? Yeah.
What if the internet would have existed for the Star Wars Christmas special?
Oh, God.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Star Wars Christmas special.
I The Last Starfighter a few nights ago. And it did not age as well as Star Wars did.
It doesn't age as well, definitely, but it's still kind of awesome.
Someone brought up the fact that Neil Blomkamp is doing an Aliens, and how excited are we? I've never seen Aliens, but I love Neil Blomkamp, I'm pretty excited.
I'm pretty excited.
I've
never seen Aliens.
Too. The only Aliens movie that I've seen is Alien Resurrection.
Me too, brother!
Yeah! And based off of that, not super into watching the rest of them. Oh, and I saw Prometheus, and I did not know it was an Aliens movie until the end. I was like, oh, hey! This is a surprise, and I think I was the only surprised one in the theater.
I will say, one of the advantages to working in the CIG community office is we actually got to find out that Neil Blomkamp was doing an Alien movie like 15 minutes before everyone else.
Yeah.
Because my brother's a Hollywood reporter, and he like texted me. And he's like, well, they're actually doing it. They're doing it. It's going to come out. So I told everybody.
And then I like Googled it, and I'm like, bull crap.
Yeah.
Nice save.
Yeah, you like that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But in terms of like your question, like I'm really excited because I really like Neil Blomkamp.
I really like Alien.
I'm pretty
Except
sad he never got to make his
Alien
movie. I think that would have been cool.
No Predators in this one, though? Are we going Predator-free Aliens?
Predator-free,
movie.
Let's hope so.
Pred-Aliens.
How long will the Orion be on sale for, Ben?
It'll be Friday to the following Monday.
Okay. So that's like normal concept sales?
Yeah, same as all the other concept sales.
I am super stoked tomorrow.
For
Orion,
the game?
Like, yeah, for that little mini game. I hope it all comes together.
I remember.
Any news on the Hull C you can share?
Not yet. No. Hull C is being developed by Jim Martin. He's the freelancer. What was his other one he did?
I don't remember.
But he did the Defiant from Deep Space Nine. So we're excited.
Sweet.
Anything we see from him, when he starts his process, he does like traditional sketches, and that's my favorite thing to see when we get from our, you know, a lot of us work in 3D initially. They do a 3D blockout and go from there. But Jim does sketches, and they're really cool.
Yeah, awesome. Hobbins did that too. Like when I watched the carrot come to be, and just like all the little hand sketches he made, I was like, this is super cool.
And the cool thing with Jim's sketches is they look just like the production sketches he would do on Star Trek 20 years ago. And whenever I said, like, oh my god, I can't believe I'm working on this project. And the guy who made my childhood spaceships is making my adult spaceships.
It takes so much longer to like be able to like actually like see something that looks like the end result. Whereas with sketching, you know, you can just sketch something in like 5 minutes and have something that relatively looks like something. So it's just for people that are like all about immediate gratification, like, yeah, starting off with sketching thumbnails is just, no matter how far the technology goes, that's still the best way to just knock out a bunch of ideas real quick.
Well, I don't know anybody in our community who likes immediate gratification.
The people here love the slow burn.
Yeah.
Is the CCU system being upgraded or reworked?
It is, eventually.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Turbulent is a little bit too many things to do right now, and REC is not helping that.
Yeah.
But it's on the schedule. In fact, we can talk about some of the other stuff they're doing. They're going to do the CCU upgrade, do some rework to the front page. You saw kind of their stopgap play now button for new users because people were being confused. They're doing something called the Community Hub, which is looking really cool. It's going to let us get a lot more content to you guys, especially fan content. What else? Organizations 2.0 is coming along really well. They're doing the star map, which you guys voted on. In fact, I think from a technical standpoint, it's pretty much ready. It's just waiting on content. We've got to tell them it's okay to show this part of the universe. So lots going on in Turbulent Town, and then plus stuff like the CCUs. They were bogged down for 2 months with this VAT tax stuff, getting that, you know, which is frustrating because they're amazing web developers. They can do incredible things for us, and then, you know, we get stuck with some legal thing that they have to spend all their time on.
Crazy powers. No, the Ryan's on sale for 10 days, not 3. I understand the confusion.
Sorry. Yeah. So, Friday weekend next Monday.
Yes. I mean, I guess we could give dates if we.
I don't know what dates are.
I think that'll be.
It's a calendar.
It'll be on sale. Damn it! Why did you see that? It'll be on sale till March 2nd, day before my birthday.
Damn it. We were having a discussion about this earlier.
I thought it was March 7th.
Nope, March 3rd.
Yeah, but it was close.
Yeah, well, your new DS is set for March 7th. I mean, we were discussing, it was 7th or 10th when we were...
Nope, 3rd.
It turns out...
What is March 3rd, your birthday?
Yep.
March 7th is PAX East.
You're 3-3, I'm 10-10.
Boom. Nailed it. Dates. Ben was nice enough to give me his old 3DS, because I lost mine. This is Chelsea powered.
Yeah, it turns out when you reset a 3DS, you can't turn it off. It just eats its battery all night, so I charged it, and then I was like, I'll just set it up for James.
Thanks, man.
Its name is James Pugh in all caps.
Can the characters age? If so, can they die of old age?
We've been talking about this. It's something CryEngine allows. It's not a priority at launch because it's such a slow thing. It's something we definitely want to do as Star Citizen grows in years and years.
I believe there was also talk of allowing your character to retire.
Yeah, that's part of the Death of a Spaceman mechanic.
Yes, Chelsea is married. I don't know how that was a question, but
I think it was just a statement.
Thanks. This is my nicest tie I own. Also, it's not mine.
Nicest tie I own. It's a nicely done knot. It's the best.
It is. I tied this myself, and I'm very proud of it.
You didn't tie it.
Somebody wants you to give me a high five. Me? For my great concierge support. Yes, you, not James.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
You saw that, internet.
Leave me hanging. Yeah.
Not James.
Yeah.
We do take questions from RSI chat for the person asking that.
Yes, in fact, when you see me looking like this, that means I'm reading RSI chat.
Yeah. By the way, Carl Sagan is awesome. One of the fan spotlight
That's
videos
true.
From yesterday was picked because they started with the Carl Sagan quote.
Nice.
James is a big boy?
Yep.
Question mark?
I'm a big boy. I got a 3DS. I got a couch.
Things are looking up. You got a desk.
I got a desk. The desk is in my car, and the couch is at my parents'
You're getting
house.
Getting your car detailed?
Getting my car detailed. I'm becoming an adult.
Things are looking up.
That's what happens when you have a birthday.
And you're in charge of a dog?
I'm in charge, yes. Someone was dumb enough to give me the rights to a dog.
Wait, what?
Did you tie looking down? What? I don't understand. Will the FPS launch with any character choice, Ben, or will they all be presets?
Still no character customization. I think there's a couple different models in there for the different teams and such, though.
I think they're working out the kinks right now of how, like, they'll be able to make lots and lots and lots of versions of, like, different clothing so that, you know, as far as, like, clipping, like, what kind of stuff's going to interact with each other and how you can make the different combinations, so... But, yeah, sooner or later that will be up and running.
Yeah, we should try and get more questions for Ken.
Yeah, he's a nice guy.
Yeah.
He's a
super nice guy.
He works on planets and stuff.
Yeah, he works on
a hospital.
Yeah, he makes crates. Like, we had a whole discussion about crates.
Oh, yeah. I remember for like 2 or 3 weeks we were talking about tarps for crates and stuff like that.
He's doing this nice, cool, like medical, futuristic thing over there. It's
yeah.
On, showed it on the tour a little bit when we did the studio tour, but it's some really cool stuff.
Nice.
Ben, if you have a large fleet, will you have to have multiple hangars?
No, you won't have to, but you can.
If you want?
Yeah.
Sweet.
So do you...
Will the Redeemer be nerfed? Sorry.
No.
Is the Redeemer going to be nerfed?
No, isn't it getting punched up? It's getting like the extra guns on the.
No, we're buffing
flanks.
It.
Yeah, it's buffing it. The ship is not in the game yet, and you can't interact with. And, so yeah, it's getting mind buffed.
What are you saying, Will? Oh, I was gonna ask Ken. Do you work with Megan and them to? Like take the concept of the characters and incorporate that into how you do like he was saying the hospital and stuff like that, or do you guys work together in that sense?
No, we haven't done anything that really does. Sorry, I'm really loud, so sorry if I'm yelling.
Stop yelling.
It's just that's my default volume, so I'll bring it down to a whisper. No, we haven't really done anything yet where like we've had to work as far as environments. I've been working on mainly stuff that's kind of like a few like locations ahead of where like Megan might be working on stuff. So for example, Megan might be working on stuff for like Terra or Art Corp, and I'd be working on stuff that, you know, we haven't really gotten as far as figuring out like the characters or NPCs and stuff like that. So,
gotcha.
But I guess there has been times where you know, it might be informative to me to see what she's doing to kind of, I guess, you know, just, I guess, help my thought process out for, like, what kind of, fashion a certain kind of people would look like on a certain location. But for the most part, our paths don't really cross too often.
Good answer.
More for Ken.
Yeah, let's get some questions for Ken.
Did we sit on who Ken is?
Yeah, no. Chasey McQueen.
I know, but did we
heard that at all?
Okay.
About the recruiting getting slid back to yes. Can you submit a ticket to support a Cloud Imperium? That way we can get that resolved for you. So.
Yep.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. When you see me using my phone like this, it just means I got some urgent request.
Did we decide on whether or not we'll include the 850Xs with each jump?
Every drop includes an 850X. Or 85X.
What ships are slated to add to the hangar in AC in 1.0? Can we say?
Well, 1.0 came out 2 months ago, so
1.1.
I'm... Oh. No, it's not a big ship addition. There's going to be... Be a ship or two, but it's not a big. It's not like 1.0 where we added 50 ships.
And the big ones, 1.1 is the big one.
1.1, it is a big patch. You're gonna see. There's a tutorial mode they're working on over in the UK. Of course, Rec is a big priority for us right now. I think those are the kind of the big pillars you're gonna see 1.1. The bigger thing about 1.1 is that it's setting the stage for two other rapid releases that are not Arena Commander. But, you know, we're moving towards FPS and social. Can't give dates for them yet, but it's a pretty tight schedule. It's the tightest schedule I've ever seen here, and so far, so good.
Nice.
Okay.
Look,
what the?
There you go. Gendry from Game of Thrones.
What's going on?
Ken's face.
Who's
this?
You're an actor, man.
I saw it in the comments.
Oh, okay. I've never watched Game of Thrones.
Oh, you don't like that?
He doesn't like Game of Thrones.
Tell me that doesn't look like Ken. Tell me.
That guy got nothing on Ken.
I did see a question for Ken, though. Have you been hiding Easter eggs from movies in your environments?
No, we haven't. Not in any of the official environments. Although, in some of my personal work, I have been known to hide Easter eggs in one of them that might be on my website, I don't know. I actually have, if you look really closely, some Star Wars Easter eggs, just because I'm that much of a fanboy, I had to put it in there. But as far as any of the Star Citizen stuff, no, not yet.
There you go. Not yet.
To answer a couple of questions on the RSI chat, do we know the price for the Orion yet? The answer is that yes, it's $325. Know where the poll for the box art is? It's not up. We're going to be putting that up just after our meetings today. Actually, yeah. We've got a couple meetings this morning, and then we'll have that up.
Yep.
Let's see. What else?
I will not watch Game of Thrones, so...
Tifa's eyes can't deal with it.
Yep.
Somebody asked
that.
Yeah.
James
watched
Game of Thrones.
To the person continuing to ask what ships are being added to AC 1.1, we can't say yet, and it's not a big ship patch, but there will be one or two.
Will there be in fiction shows like the Empire Report and Galactic Gear?
Yes. A good example of this is the Empire Report. and Galactic. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, you gave two examples of the thing you asked if they existed in the question.
A hard yes, yeah.
And in fact, one thing we want to do as we move towards release is kind of transition some of our current shows over into the universe. You know, in once the PU launches, you're not going to want to know so much about the making of Star Citizen, but you're going to know what's going on in Star Citizen. So Empire Report is part of that.
How much do you like the dude?
Jeff Bridges?
Yes, Jeff Bridges.
Just
throw out the newscast. What's his name? The newscaster. In Empire Report.
Alan Nuevo?
Yes. He's my hero.
Alan Nuevo and Beck Russo.
Oh.
Sandy
Walker? No, it was another woman that they thought was Sandy. Somebody going to Toby Office. What of the car through all? Anything more soon? I believe we talked about it today around the verse.
Travis
and Darian.
Yeah, Travis did.
It's started, which I'm excited for, finally.
I actually specifically pulled that news bit for you.
Thanks.
So I was like, James is going to be stoked.
It's the best ship in the game.
Uh-huh.
How do we plan on handling voice acting in the NPCs in the PU? Will everyone have it, or will there be text bubbles?
That is not one we can answer yet.
Sure.
But as with anything this size, you lean towards voice acting and you settle for speech bubbles if it has to happen.
Yep. Jeff Bridges.
By the way, Chris Roberts pretty much invented voiceovers in a video game. Wing Commander 2 was, for years, Creative Labs would have at their site, you know, they would credit Wing Commander 2 with the reason Sound Blaster is still the standard for PC audio today. Because everybody wanted to show off the introduction to Wing Commander 2, where the Karathi speak of your plans, not of your toys. Tell me how you will defeat the Terrans. And it was just guys at Origin doing the funny voices, but it changed the world.
Oh shit! You want to tell them about the discovery you found in Wing Commander?
Oh yeah, I made a weird discovery in Wing Commander 3 yesterday. If you hit Alt S and went to loadout screens, you got like a page of in-universe flavor text. Discovering things in Wing Commander from 20 years ago. It's been a weird...
So, this question keeps on getting asked, and it's apparently very important. Will there be any potatoes or other veggies in the game?
A potato a vegetable? Isn't it a starch?
That's silly.
Yeah,
it's a starch. It's a potato's kind of like more like a grain.
Yeah,
it's like a delicious underground rock.
Potato is not a
it's
grain.
A delicious it's underground a rock.
It's a root vegetable. It's a root vegetable.
No, it's a delicious underground rock. We already established that.
Probably.
No.
Yes.
There we go.
No,
that
no
question
potatoes.
Doesn't have to
no,
happen.
No,
you know
again.
What? I'm taking a hard stand.
Out.
No potatoes.
Potatoes.
Whoa, bro.
Star Citizen have a vegan friendly.
No.
Because James knows that that's what I'm into.
Yep.
Vegan.
Well, there's a Vega system.
That's right.
In fact, I think it's where the original trailer took place.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice. Delicious underground rock confirmed.
How many potatoes can we fit in a reclaimer?
Is there a plan for a loyalty program besides subscription models available at the moment in terms of tiering rewards per X amount pledged?
Not as you described, although we are working on a... what do you call it?
What?
Recruit.
Recruit. Yeah, we're working on a. Yeah, then we're working on a. It's not called recruiting. What is referral? We're working on some referral stuff. Again, turbulent someday.
We got a question for Ken.
Or turbulent. How's like
the plan
design
environment modularity coming along?
So our tech artist here, Court Sos, is pretty much like leading the way with that and is kicking the butt. They're developing a whole bunch of like tools for the engine to make that streamlined, and it is as far as the tools and stuff like that, that's kind of still getting kind of fleshed out. But once it does, we are going to be able to start making tons and tons and tons of environments because we already have lots of art and lots of assets. So that's when we'll be able to start using all that tons of artwork and tons of like, you know, models and textures to then kind of use those as kind of like almost like kind of like Lego blocks, you know, to then just make like, you know, hundreds and hundreds of variations. And the nice thing with the tools and using that in conjunction with all the different art is we can, you know, even though we'll be using, you know, a lot of the same assets to make tons and tons of different environments, we can, you know, we can set dress or we can add, you know, unique things. We can change, you know, environments, climate, and other kind of stuff to make each individual environment unique. So even though they'll be using a lot of the same assets, nothing will look the same. Everything will be unique.
Now he's sitting up
and still. So yeah, so in the next few months, that's when it's going to really start, I think, kind of really coming together, and we'll be really banging out tons and tons of awesome, awesome places. So yeah, it's exciting. Yeah, there might be sand people on some of the planets.
By the way, guys, someone asked when we would do a design post on fuel consumption, that sort of thing. It's not on our schedule right now, but if you guys would like to start a thread on the forum, then maybe we can start it afterwards. We would love to hear what design posts you'd like to see, because we schedule them out about 2 months in advance, and then we every month we look at the next month. So we're getting close to that happening again. So tell us what you'd like to see in the design deep dives coming up. We're really proud of our ability to do those now. We want to keep them regular and keep informing you about the game, because, you know, the number one criticism of any game ever just seems to be the generic thing. And I see about Star Citizen, we don't know anything about the game. Like, we post something every day. Sometimes we post seven novels worth of information about the game. We have 2-3 television shows every week about the game, and we want to keep you as informed as possible. And the best, you know, it's the best response to that criticism is, well, just go look. So let us know what you want to see, and we will make it happen.
Harcroft wants to know, how many shots does it take to make me and Alexis as nice as we are with so many thousands of room tickets? Zero. This is just us.
Although
you
we
just
do,
can't take it personally.
Yeah, we do swear a lot sometimes.
We get it out, you know, speak our mind, and then we answer nicely.
Yeah.
There was one where you couldn't stop laughing for like 5 minutes recently.
Right. Wow. What was that about?
I don't even remember.
Some of them do make us laugh.
Yeah.
Probably. It's amazing.
Oh, beans.
Even the mean ones.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah. That doesn't mean you should try to write in and be mean.
No. Yeah, all you bleep bleepers out there who send dick messages to CS, we're laughing at you.
Well, what else can you do? You're going to laugh, you're going to cry, yeah. You're going to laugh, you know?
And then we know your name, which you don't want us to
yeah. Yeah, yeah, they literally get like a screen that's like, I'm gonna kill you, you ruined my whatever, I'm gonna hurt your family, blah, 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 blah. And then there's a screen that's like, I am a 17-year-old and I live at this place and here's my parents' phone number. So, these ladies get the last laugh.
Mm-hmm. Now I'm
talking cut. Exactly.
That would not be PG. Did everybody have a good Valentine's Day?
Yeah?
Yeah, alright. Let's do that. Talk
we went
about
to the
it.
Drive-in.
What?
Driving movies? That was fun.
Oh, sweet.
That's cool.
What'd you go see?
Kingsman and Spare Parts.
How's Kingsman? So did it still have the big blocky like thing yes. Hanging on the window or no? I'm driving the drive-in theater.
Yes.
Or am I way off of what you want to go do?
Yeah, through the radio.
Oh, it goes through the radio? Oh. When I was a kid it was like you had to pull up to the speaker. And you pull off the speaker and hang it on your window.
They've upgraded a bit.
Whoa.
Were you a kid in the 1950s?
Yeah.
Did you have to hold the boombox up?
Yeah, exactly. Pull out cardboard and dance
question.
On it.
What's your favorite planet side environment so far?
I would have to say ArcCorp. Just, I tend to like all of the like kind of grittier, kind of, I don't know, dicey environments, and ArcCorp is definitely going to have a good mix of safe and not so safe areas, and also just the look of like the skyline when you're approaching it, it's just so cool, it's so cool. So I'd have to say ArcCorp so far though, but Terra is shaping up to look pretty awesome.
To be continued.
Yeah. Terra is pretty awesome too. They're all so cool. Like every time I see like what some of the level designers are kind of blocking out, I'm like, oh god, this is gonna be so cool.
Pretty cool.
So yeah. All of them.
All of them. Nice.
By the way, to answer the Valentine's Day question, heart-shaped pizza.
Oh yeah, how was that?
It was very good.
It was heart-shaped.
It was, yeah.
That was the main selling point, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, I want to know where you get your t-shirts, Lil.
I get them from tmagnet.com. It combines like a whole bunch of daily t-shirt websites. But I actually got this one for Christmas, because I love Back to the Future. I think I have 4 or 5 Back to the Future shirts now.
Did you see the DeLorean iPhone case?
Yeah, it's
$50
bucks and it's only for iPhone 6. I almost decided to upgrade to an iPhone 6 because of it. I also have both the DeLorean Hallmark Christmas ornaments. And I'm waiting for the third one, so get on it, Hallmark.
There used to be a DeLorean VHS tape rewinder back when I was a kid. That would be awesome.
Well, I'm just going to look up for that on eBay. So, Back to the Future is awesome.
Go to like the defunct. Best.
Yeah.
No, like Blockbuster used to have them all lined up on the
counter. Yeah. I used to work on Hollywood Video. We used to have them lined up.
Yep.
I worked at Blockbuster for a week.
You did?
Yeah. We got robbed at gunpoint, so I was like, I don't think I want to do this anymore. That's what you said.
That took a violent turn.
So in the week I was working there, I got a Happy Feet t-shirt, so I think I may not be good.
Yeah,
yeah.
Get a gun pointed at you, get a shirt. All right. Yeah. That's how I get all my shirts, is I get guns pointed at me all day.
Luckily, I was not there when it happened. Oh, but I heard about it, and I was like, you know what? I don't really like this job anyways, so I'm just not going to go anymore.
I'm surprised that they got a gun in, because they have those metal detectors at the entrance and exit, right? Because they don't want you stealing the tapes.
Well, I guess if you're willing to rob a Blockbuster, I don't think a metal detector is really going to stop you.
True.
I had a friend that worked at a Blockbuster, and he bought me a life-size Iron Man cutout for my birthday. He had a whole bunch of those there, and he's like, here's your birthday present. I lost my mind. It was amazing.
I just don't imagine Blockbuster and Iron Man existing at the same time.
No.
Someone asked about Squadron 42 in the AMD packs, why it's no longer included. That's a contract with AMD, nothing we can do about it. The initial batch did include it, and the ones after February 1st do not.
I got in on the initial batch, sorry guys.
Alexis, what are your favorite ships?
Alright.
I like
the Scythe. Scythe is cool.
The 300.
Yeah, what's your favorite
I like
ship?
The M50.
Favorite ships, like
the racing ships.
Because it looks M50's like cool. It kill you.
It bring death.
Yeah, you look at it and you're like, hey, there's not nice people in there.
And Alexis, you like the M50?
Mm-hmm.
I like it too. It's slick, fast.
Looks cool.
Yeah.
Cool, I still think the M50 has the coolest concept art. Like, it looks real on that tarmac.
Yeah.
Like that.
I was starting to like Mustangs more and more, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What a cool Mustang granite.
Cool design.
Yeah. Thanks, Hobbins.
Do we know who's going to PAX East yet?
No, we don't.
Never
did. Why not, Ben?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a good question.
Trevor Bump.
Hey, it's Trevor.
Still get there.
When will the hoodies be available again? Not at any point in the near future, but perhaps next year we can do another run of new hoodies.
Hoodies!
And that's another one. You know, rally if you want them. Our initial batch of hoodies were not... they didn't fly off the shelves, so...
But we are working on, looking into a baseball cap, a coffee mug, travel coffee mug, and some other stuff.
In fact, we sent off to our guys in China for the baseball cap. They'll send us samples of stuff they do at their factory. We got like a huge box of like bootlegged baseball caps,
uh-huh.
Like fake Yankees caps. I have like a leopard print one that says money.
It does. It's the best one.
Yeah, go grab the money cap.
Is it on your desk?
It's on the cover.
But for the record, they're very good quality.
They're very good quality. They're nicer than.
Do we need those Seahawks Super Bowl champions shirts?
No, those are going to starving children in third world countries, along with the losing ship from TNGS.
Here's the money hat, and here's the Wing Commander helmet.
Oh yeah, this is the Wing Commander helmet. And money.
I like the cheetah print on it. Or is that leopard? I don't know.
I think it's leopard.
I think it's leopard. I think it's leopard.
Yes, Travis and Darian will have a better cam mic for next week's news update. In fact, we're thinking about getting a default good sounding mic and sending it out to each of the studios so it's easier.
By the way, I have a giant head, so no hats fit me.
Challenge accepted.
We did the merchantman, right?
Yeah, we did the merchantman.
Okay, good. Right.
News about the Retaliator. Retaliator is very, very close. It's waiting for stuff from the 1.1 branch of the game. Mm-hmm. It's coming.
What?
Someone said you look like a movie director.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Yeah, I guess I do kind of look like fat Stanley Kubrick.
Someone said you look like Michael Moore.
Yep. Yeah, I can see that.
I see it.
Yeah, Stanley Kubrick is better.
Hey, can one of you guys from the Austin office go ask Richard Garriott a question? Just walk down to Portalarium and ask about the Sword of the Avatar.
Yeah, we don't actually work with Richard Garriott. We're just pals.
Pals.
We're game pals.
Dude, I got to interview Richard Garriott. It was crazy. I did not remember the origin tagline. I felt stupid.
By the way, guys, I have a new name for the RSI Museum. What if we call it Origin Stories instead? Okay with that?
For 30 seconds, we'll know.
Yeah, 30 seconds, we'll know.
Can we show us some Retaliator awesomeness, please?
Then
I want you to draw Retaliator.
We can't show you the Retaliator today, but I have it in good authority that the Retaliator today went for white boxing, which is where they generate the store renders. So make what you will of that.
Jeez. Soon TM.
Status of the Galactopedia. We're still working on it.
The your first dip of the Galactopedia is going to be the star map, which is just waiting. It's largely waiting on content. Have you said that already?
Will the Starfare and the Retaliator be ready for 1.1?
1.1, no.
No.
Wait, well, okay, not the Starfarer for sure, but leave it at that.
So in case anyone wanted to see what a Lego Womp Rat looked like, that's a Lego Womp Rat right there.
Alright! It has two little spots on the bottom where you put the actual Lego pieces. That's what I was curious about. But yeah. Ryan finished his model.
Yeah, he did that while we were sitting here. That's pretty impressive if you ask me.
Yeah.
Alright, well, let's send him one of those, like, UCS kits, and he can...
Did this actually like, shoot across the room, though?
Yes.
Was I correct in thinking that?
Yeah.
That's a little frightening.
Sorry.
Eyeballs.
Now, in the actual design, I do not think that the wings have lasers like that. But, you know, that's just me.
Compared to his model on his desk, see how accurate Lego made it. But mine's got two missiles and a gun.
It's a modded one.
Alright, so for...
Any questions, anybody? We got like 7 minutes left.
Wait, it's gotta have lasers. What? How else does he bullseye the Rump Rats?
Well, it's got a main gun in the middle, but this one's got like added guns on the side of the wings.
Hardcraft, if you want an update on the Lego Anvil Hornet, you're going to have to talk to Lego, because
Yes, Carl Lego.
So well, in case you don't watch
the
weekly Lego videos like some of us do, the Lego does like videos like
where
they talk about new Lego sets.
Reverse the Lego.
The Lego Hornet is it's in their next review phase with a bunch of other things. We have no insight on the process. It all takes place inside the like Lego complex in Billund, Denmark somewhere. But from the other options, we're cautiously optimistic.
Yeah. But I'd say it's amazing that we even got this far. Like, it's super cool.
Party. Will there be robots/drones in the game, Ben?
Yes.
I robot.
Yeah, there will be drones. I don't know about robots. If I had seen it, there would be, but...
Oh, no, there's...
I love robots. Well,
there's
the mining robot, right?
There's the mining bot. There's the repair droid that we gave everybody already. So.
Well, yeah, there's those. I'm thinking of like
C-3PO,
R2-D2 robots, droids.
That's the idea. The repair bot is it's basically our equivalent of a pet right now. So.
Ken-2-D2 nailed it.
Ken is not impressed.
a World of Warcraft pet, so it's your R2-D2 that follows you around.
Will James, Ben, Jen draw off? Terrible.
We can't do that every week.
You gotta keep it special.
Yeah.
But check out my Instagram for amazing drawing of my wife.
Did you just plug your Instagram?
He did. Check me up on Instagram, bros. I'm getting ready for South by Southwest.
You need your money hat while you say that.
Yeah.
Brock, can you check my clout?
Score like?
What's your reach? Hey, Sandy.
Hello.
That was Sandy. And maybe we could entice her to come say hi before we wrap this up.
Nope.
Sandy, come say hi.
Come say hi to the community.
No,
hi.
No, to me.
Yeah. Hi, James.
Hi, James.
How you doing?
Why are you wearing a tie?
Fancy Thursday.
I missed the memo.
Yeah. Sorry.
Why is Will look so serious?
He's always serious.
Oh. He does. He looks concerned over there.
Will's never happy.
I'm always concerned. Listen to the audio levels, the bumping out of Austin. I'm. This is tense time.
How was ATV? What did it be?
You guys like, tell us, what do you think of ATV right now?
Verse?
In 30 seconds, we'll know.
We'll know in 30 seconds, yeah.
They say you didn't sound happy when you said hi, James.
Oh, hi, James.
How you doing?
Hi, James.
Now, you didn't sound happy, James.
Will the modularity system be active in 1.1?
What could the first ship out? No, that's down the line.
So no, this guy liked ATV. There you go. ATV awesome, but needs more news on the Vanguard. Oh yeah, the Bulldog. My bad. Forgot.
That shouldn't be too far away.
Lossy audio.
I think they're saying bad audio for the ATV.
It's for the.
For the studio segments.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We need to.
I think we have a fix for that.
Yeah, we're working on that. How's the flight training going?
I had this dream last night that, like, I got into the game in the match. What?
I said, this is going to be good.
Yeah, I wonder what Sandy dreams about.
And I just kept getting shot down. Like, I just was, like, dying. I just got out there and dead.
Well, that's actually, so, like...
I think I need to change my handle because Sandy G is pretty obvious.
Yeah.
We'll make you a fake identity.
That's if we ever do play, because we have CIG in it, we just get destroyed.
How many people do we have on our team now? We have 6, right? Team 1 has 6 and a Romanito ghost.
Yes. Romanito was the MVP.
Yeah.
How do you friend us, by the way? How does that work?
I don't know. How he found us in particular, especially when nothing else in the game was working. But
shout out
Romanito
to Romanito.
Yeah, Romanito's watching. You're a hero.
A lot of people want to know, is there any update on the HOTAS, the Star Citizen one?
Yeah, I need to push that. There's some funky red liners in the deal that I, when it gets in the legal department, it gets funky.
Toast!
Yeah, legal.
We know.
Good job, Toast.
Toast makes all of our jobs more difficult.
So you're just walking by and her though. What happened to the awesome mining spider?
What mining spider?
It's Squadron 42 on us.
Oh, that one.
The mining spider still exists. You're going to see it in the Squadron 42 intro.
Cool.
10:59.
Yeah, no, you guys are back in the wind tunnel over in Austin.
Hey, by the way, does anybody have a Bob?
What?
Bob? It's called Bob. It's like my boxing trainer was telling me. It's about your size, actually.
Okay. Oh, the...
Is it like a life-size
dummy?
Yeah.
Oh.
I know a Bob, but I don't know if he'll let you punch him.
I've got a big stand-up Mark Hamill.
For some reason, that's...
That's
scary.
That's hidden in a corner in our house.
Yeah, it's one of the first things she did when she moved. I was like, nope.
Well, when I first moved to Austin with Ben, I got there and in our bedroom was a Mark Hamill stand-up in the corner.
Oh, that's crazy.
We had a
Solo and a Chewbacca one in my old apartment.
Deal breaker.
We found them in the trash and we just picked them up and put them in our house.
Well, I should clarify. This is not Star Wars Mark Hamill. This is Wing Commander
Four
Mark Hamill.
Oh. So,
that didn't change anything for me.
All right, it's 11. Will, who
are you? All right, well, thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. We will have a lot of stuff coming out tomorrow, so be sure to tune into the website, and the Orion sale is going to happen, and it's going to have an awesome minigame. And we will catch you guys next week. Thank you to Ken for tuning in, and thanks to the Austin guys. Hopefully we'll figure out the wind tunnel and everything.
So. Oh, and we're going to say Jerry's going to be here next week, so you will see her with us.
Exactly.
Instead of an Austin.
So,
wait, turn free.
Thank you, everybody, and we'll catch you guys next week.
Bye, guys.